Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to use some balloons to show the quarks going from a proton to a neutron. So I'm going to show you how to tape up some balloons here so we can reuse them. We don't want to tie them off. And plus charge, electromagnetic force charges. Electromagnetic is the plus minus thing, right? Well, these are fractional. And that's why you get plus 2/3 for an up, minus 1/3 for a down. So the fractions come out to be a plus 1 for a proton and a neutral for a neutron. So it's funny that new, N-E-W, and neutral are both for the neutron, because the sun takes protons, and when it fuses them, it makes a neutron. Helium is later. So the first part of chemistry has to do with the nuclear processes that are happening in stars. Our star is actually a third generation star, but it's doing what other stars did in the first generation. So protons, two ups and a down, are held by gluons. So each quark gets one gluon. That's why over here the deuteron is going to be a neutron and a proton that's bound together. See, two protons won't stick together. They'll fall apart. A neutron will decay by itself within 20 minutes on average, 12 minutes or so in a room temperature or something. So in a star, what happens is two neutrons won't stick together, two protons won't stick together. So for any other element to be made, you have to have a proton and a neutron. If two protons come together, that's chemistry, would create an H2 molecule. Well, those protons aren't together. They're bound by electrons. So this is in the nucleus. There's no electrons involved yet. And to balance, there's four different things we need to consider. The electromagnetic charge, we have to balance that. We have to balance the mass. There's a thing called spin. And so we won't get into too much of that. But the four particles that we're going to consider in a proton going to a neutron, it's going to be a down quark, a positron, and the neutrino. So up quark, down quark, positron, neutrino. Four particles that we need to consider. And all the matter in the world that we know of is made of this. Okay? We won't talk about antimatter. Well, positron is antimatter, but there's a thing called pair production that I don't want to get into because it'll just confuse a lot of you. So don't get confused yet, because all we're going to do is use balloons. Okay, red is positive, green negative. Well, what is green? Green is the down quark. So hang tight, we're going to get to it. So the reactions that we're going to be doing here, I want to show how we're going to take a balloon. Blue is the biggest, to show that neutrons are going to be bigger than the protons. Now what you do to, instead of tying them, is you twist it up here. So get a good couple twists around there, right? So you got the twist in there. Take a piece masking tape one. Anyway, just put tape around it real tight. And what you'll end up with is it looking a little bit like this one here. Okay? So. Two up quarks and a down quark. This is, looks just like the Mickey Mouse water molecule, but this is in the nucleus. Up quark, down quark. So now when you look, you say, what's more massive, an up quark or a down quark? Well, you look, it's a no-brainer. These have fractional charges. All you need to remember is plus two-thirds, minus a third. Reds are plus two-thirds. So if you study this little diagram here, the protons are the little sleepy guys. See, two ups and the down, and it look like a little just sleeping, because this is what they were doing. When the Big Bang happened, all the protons essentially were sent out in a mass majority, hydrogen they call it, still the most abundant element particle out there. So they were out there kind of just sleeping because they wouldn't react with anything. Then the gravity pulls into the picture, pulls them together. Now when they fuse, this is the step you need to know. Two ups and a down. Two ups and a down is going to go on to be, an up is going to become more massive. So now you got two downs and an up. This is the neutron. So see, a neutron is more massive. Minus a third, plus two-thirds. The electromagnetic value goes to zero. So electromagnetically, neutron, no charge. Mass, it's got more mass than the proton. Now, in order for an up to become a down, up becomes a down. What you end up with is an antiparticle. The difference in mass is a positive electron. So kind of picture this being taken away from that. And then in order to get the spin involved, you'd have the little neutrino. So up quark, you need two of the... This is inside the proton. So when two protons come together, the fusion that they talk about in the sun, our sun is a perfect example. The sun is going to make one of those two protons into a neutron. So what's it going to do? Up, quark. There's still another up and a down in there. The up goes to a more massive down. And in order to compensate for the mass, it has to make antimatter. So the positron, in order to conserve spin, then has a neutrino that comes off with it. So for the longest time, they were thinking neutrinos were massless. But they're finding out now that neutrinos can change their character. They can even go from an electron neutrino to a muon neutrino to a tau neutrino, and they kind of vibrate in between. It's beyond the scope of this talk. So the particles we need, now when you look... Neutrino, that's the tiniest. Positron, that's an antimatter electron. The first reaction in the sun makes antimatter. And that's a whole plus one. This is what's kind of amazing. An electron is one, almost 2,000th the size of a giant proton. But it's got the same electromagnetic amount, even though it's opposite in charge. So a whole proton with the two up and one down quarks ends up with an overall plus one charge. Well, an electron has a negative one charge, but it doesn't have near the mass. This is something that's fascinating that they don't tell you about in the books. They just act like, you know, memorize this. So again, what you need to know is the stars, the first thing that needs to be made is a neutron, because two protons won't stick together. Two neutrons won't stick together. A neutron will actually decay back to a proton by kicking out, not a positron, but a real electron with an antineutrino. So neutrons need protons just as much as protons need neutrons. So when you get this, it's still chemically called a hydrogen atom. And this is what's confusing. It's just the way that they were discovered in history that it's progressed now almost 100 years later to have these names still. So deut means two because it's got a mass of two, roughly. This is the nucleus. So being that tiny, the neutron and proton are almost the same mass, the difference by an electron. Remember, one 1830 seconds worth. So this is called a deuteron. If it's got an electron with it, it's called deuterium. Then it's the hydrogen atom. But now it's just a nucleus, because inside the sun, 15 million degrees, too high in energy. Electrons are all pushed outside. In the core of these stars is where you got just the nuclei. That's the inner part. The electrons are way out there. So know this. Know that the sun is making neutrons. They're new. And they're made from protons. And in order to make more mass, you have to have an equal but opposite antimatter. Antimass. The sun is making it. It's positron. I run into graduate chemistry majors, and they think antimatter is something like science fiction that you see on Star Trek, but it's real. PET, positron emission tomography. Almost every hospital in the world now does that. That's antimatter that's made. So if you can get this one reaction down, this is what's so cool. Now what holds these quarks together... See, this is a neutron now, so see, two downs are bigger and one little up. So each quark, when it starts bonding, you get three of these now, is held by a gluon. That's why you get a total of six. If you draw this neutron bunny here, it's the best expression. Proton... two up quarks and a down. More massive is a neutron, two downs and an up, and these stick together. I often wonder if the quarks get involved and start, you know, mingling. But for all general purposes, this isn't its own little entity, a neutron. This is a proton, and when they bond together, it'd probably be something kind of like this. And these form shells now. Some say lithium, I think 11, has a halo where they start getting some of these orbiting outside the inner part of the nucleus. So, to use balloons to learn this, what's more massive? Can you see it there? Two greens and the red is more massive than the two reds and one green. So again, there's your neutron. There's your proton come together with six gluons to hold it together.